This is the message of my dance.
So the chances are, you've looked in at least one mirror today. You had a shave, or you combed your hair, or maybe you checked your teeth for spinach after lunch. But what you didn't know is that the face looking back at you isn't the face that everybody else sees. It's a kind of reversed, distorted, back to front image. If you take two mirrors and you put them together at right angles and you take the seam away, the images bounce off each other, and what you see when you look in a true mirror is exactly what other people see when they look at you. So the difference is, when you look in a regular mirror, you look for reassurance. You look for reassurance that you're beautiful, or you're young, or you're tidy, or your bum doesn't look big in that. But when you look in a true mirror, you don't look at yourself, you look for yourself. And the two places in life where you are awesome at being yourself, you're fantastic at being yourself. One of them is when you're a kid. When you're a kid, you're fantastic at being yourself because you don't know how to disguise your differentness. And from then on, you become more self-conscious and by default less good at being yourself.
Sing it. We will rock you. We will rock you.
You put your right foot out, you put your right foot in, and you shake it all about.
You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
The most visible you that you represent to the outside world is what everybody else thinks of you. And there are as many opinions of you as there are people. You will never, ever be perception-less, but it's important to be perception-free.
Everybody wants me to be what they want me to be. I'm not happy when I try to fake it. No. Why I'm easy.
Now, there are certain times in your life that lend themselves to change, that make change quicker, deeper. And I call them intervals of possibility. But you know, there's times in your life when you come to a bifurcation on the path and you sense that the potential for change is heightened. That if you make that change, the speed of your life will change. Now, unfortunately, some of these interventions, some of these intervals of possibility are catastrophic. In fact, most of them are catastrophic because most of us would rather sleepwalk until something happens to wake us up.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality.
So when you think about your identity, when you think about what it means to be alive, when you think about why you deserve to exist, you're not your thoughts, because you think them. And you can't be your feelings, because otherwise, who's the you that feels them? You're not what you have. You're not what you do. You're not even who you love or who loves you. There has to be something underneath all that. If you can tap into that inner voice that I've been talking about, not only will the speed of your life get quicker, not only will the substance of your life get richer, but you will never feel superfluous again.
to take a chance, learn how to fly, change the circumstance in the blink of an eye. Time to learn to rise, learn how to fall, count your blessings in spite of it all. Doubts, question the plans. I see through the clouds, I know who I am. Can't feel the sun.